Yeah.
Wow, it's dark.
I'm all right. How are you doing? How are you?
Sorry about your loss. I just found out yesterday.
I
was gone last week.
You want Adrian?
Don't lose that one. If we need to do
further, well, we're off to a slow start here. 10 minutes late.
Short fat fella like me. I stood the corner most of my school.
What's your, what's your phone say? Well, that's better. I want to go to Church Hill tonight.
I'm proud of you.
I got to get out of here. It's going to take 15 minutes to get to Church Hill.
We don't care.
She needs a statement. Miss Ray, why don't you get her a new statement? Because hers is broke. It'll still stay good.
I got you.
Yeah, she saved paper.
Yeah. Oh, it's not as bad as I thought. I guess they set their clock forward so that you're always early. Wait, I my 10 minutes, 7 minutes fast. If somebody's watching, can you tell me if the picture is right or is it sideways?
To open this Transportation Committee meeting of the Hawkins County Board of Education, this being June 19, 2018. This being a committee meeting, we can only strive to make recommendations that would be forwarded on to the full board. No decisions will be made here tonight, as to be factual. Recommendations only. This committee meeting was brought to the table for the purpose of discussing a petition that was presented to our busing superintendent, Mr. Bunch, by a number of our bus drivers. Our bus drivers had listed some concerns, and that's what we're here to discuss tonight, to come up with these recommendations. During this meeting, I'd like to take this opportunity to, for lack of a better term, lay down some ground rules. I would prefer, if someone had a question, to be recognized. Let's try not to, if someone asks a question, don't stand up and ask the same question again. Let's try to get through the material, come to an understanding, get the facts, because we're all in this together. I want to thank each and every person to come to this meeting tonight. I see a lot of bus drivers. You're very important to this system. Of course, you've heard me say that before. You see, you're the first ones to see our students, and you're the last ones to see our students. You're part of this team. And we're going to take the time and the due diligence with this committee to get to where we need to get to. So, with that being said, we do have an agenda. Everyone will see a bus driver job description. Has everybody got that? Any questions on that or anything? Do we have a spokesperson for that would be willing to speak for the bus drivers?
Darrell Lawson.
Darrell, thank you. So if we have some questions, we can direct them toward you. Is that correct? Is that acceptable to the committee?
What was the question?
If we have any questions, that we direct them to Mr. Darrell Lawson. And let's be relaxed in here tonight and try to work through this because what's the real reason we're here? I'm going to say it. It's for the kids, okay? So if we can read through this or if anybody has any questions about it, Mr. Lawson, do the drivers have any issues with the duties and responsibilities of a bus driver?
The bus drivers are concerned about the responsibilities and the liabilities that has been mandated on us by state and federal laws. And we know that we're liable for each child that's on that bus and a responsibility for it. And we do know that the liability comes back on us. And we feel like that if we have to live up to the mandates of state and federal law and be responsible for all these children to try to get them to get an education from home, that we should be recompensed a fair wage for our responsibilities.
Okay. Thank you very much. Number four on the agenda is bus driver concerns. And I've labeled them A through E. Now, in my conversations with some of the bus drivers, I would like, with your permission, Mr. Lawson, I'd like to go through some of these concerns.
Would like what?
I would like to be able to present some of these concerns. Or would you rather do that?
You go ahead and do
okay,
it.
Okay, thank you. A is working conditions, and I think Mr. Lawson's just answered that question. There's a lot of responsibility. Of course, we all know that. We do know that our equipment's in good shape. Mr. Punch does, and his staff does a fantastic job, I think, keeping our buses and equipment up to the qualifications that are required by the Department of Transportation. Am I correct? Okay. Going through my notes. I'm just going to read them off. You've got some concerns about working conditions, communication, responsibilities and duties, pay scale, and compensation for training. And then some of you had some ideas about educating our students for safety and proper conduct on a bus. Okay, so let's just take these. I've been giving some thought to the communication issue, and that goes along with conditions. And I've been giving it some thought and talking to some different folks. And what I would like to do, I'd like to recommend to the board. And I haven't talked to all the bus drivers. I've talked to a small number of bus drivers. But in order to get the broader picture, the full scope of everything, the true opinion of what's going on, I would like to take the opportunity to recommend developing a survey to be given to the bus drivers. It could be an anonymous survey. It could be, or you could sign it. It wouldn't matter. Well, not that type of survey. I'm thinking something where you ask the problem questions. How do you feel? What are your concerns? What are you unhappy with? Not just a check A, B, C, or D, but let's get straight to the point and give the drivers an opportunity to express themselves. Because there's how many bus drivers we got, Mr. Bunch?
Well, we've got on our scale, we've got about 115, and that includes every driver that we have that has a driver's license, a CDL for Hawkins County. Now, are all those bus drivers that drive buses? No, that's people that possess a school bus license.
Here again, it's sheer logistics. I would love to be able to speak to each and every person that's involved with our transportation department. It's impossible. And I'm sure every member on this committee would like to have that opportunity. But a survey may fill that void for us. But that's, like I say, it's a recommendation. I'm asking you guys, because we're here as a group. So I'm open to the floor is in agreement.
Well, I think a survey is very appropriate. We do surveys all the time with the teachers, principals, to see what their feelings are and concerns. So a survey would be very appropriate.
Mr. Lawson?
I think that you would get the feelings of a lot of bus drivers by a survey. They would be more apt to answer their true feelings on paper than they would be a lot of times in books.
Okay.
And I agree with that. But listen, this meeting ends on a petition. They have some kind of concerns and opinions, so we need to hear them.
Okay. Aiden?
I concur. I concur.
Mr. Sheriff? Mr. Funk?
Yep.
Okay. Now, moving forward with that, developing this survey, Ms. Bailey, is that something that your staff would be able to tackle, or is that an obligation that this committee would need to get together to develop a set of questions?
I think maybe some of the committee members or all the committee members, including
Mr. Lawson,
could work together to develop a survey. I could develop a survey, but I've never driven a bus, so.
Okay.
I could not get, maybe to some of the questions.
Well, if we can, let's just nail this down as we go. It's summertime, people's been going on vacation, and this is somewhat of we need to expedite this. Would it be acceptable to ask each member of this committee to come up with 3 questions and submit them to me, or do I have a volunteer that wanted to head this survey up?
I'm not making eye contact.
Hey, if this was an MOU, Anybody
I'll
volunteer?
I'll do it.
Okay. If each committee member could come up with 3 viable questions, more than that, that'd be about 20 questions, and then submit those questions. Jack, is that okay? All right, and Mr. Lawson, you can submit those questions too.
Yeah, and I think too, just in the scope of that, once we develop this survey and we get the questions all in, I think it would be good if Mr. Lawson came back with us and looked if there's any fill in the blanks that we missed.
No, I agree.
That your guys would share with you to come up with yours, and then once we compile ours, if we're missing any vital questions for the survey, I'd like for